Welcome back to my channel. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and all the good stuff. Today we have a bit of Mackenzie Edwards' IG. She goes a little bit into what's coming up next. I thought it might be interesting. So here it is.
So excited to finally be able to talk about what I have had going on the past. It's been a minute. So I haven't said anything about it lately, and I think it's time to kind of address the elephant in the room. And so, no, we are not doing Teen Mom at this point in time. And I, before this happened, you know, I was just kind of praying, like, God, whatever you have in store for us, like, let us follow that because I'm a believer, Ryan's a believer, and we both believe that if we follow our hearts and follow God's plan, then He is going to open up doors for us that have never been opened before. So what I was saying is, that was our prayer, and you know, we were, have been having this conversation for a long time, but it's hard to pull the trigger, I mean, on something like that. So we got the phone call saying, hey, you know, we're not going to be doing Teen Mom anymore. And we both kind of felt like this peace. And most of the time, you know, you'd start shaking like a leaf because, like, that is, you know, a primary source of income. Well, I have been putting together a fitness plan since I started my fitness journey close to a year ago. And I have decided that I'm going to, or I had decided that I was going to curate a plan with trainers, and I got a team together. And so we are finally making that dream a reality. And I'm so excited. It's a 12-week challenge, turned it into a challenge. So it is so streamlined. It focuses on your food and your exercise, and really just kind of getting healthy from the inside out. And I'm never, and at the end of this month, we are going to launch our 12-week challenge, and I am so excited. So watch for more information on that soon. So with this challenge, I've put a lot of blood, sweat, tears, time, and money into this, and I'm just hoping, you know, even if it's just one person, that I can help them feel their best, look their best, be their best. You know, because I feel like fitness really gave me an outlet during COVID, and a lot of the things that you didn't see on Teen Mom, which rightly so has nothing to do with me, they were not documented. Kind of went through a pretty dark time, and fitness kind of gave me an outlet. So I'm hoping that if you resonate with that and can give me, so if you can give me 30 minutes of your day, you can be successful as well on your fitness journey. So I can't wait to see you then. I'll provide more updates soon.
We've all heard over the last sort of couple of days to a week or wherever it's been that Macy has got Ryan and all the Edwards family fired. Now, I think I've said this before and I've said it on a live. This pisses me off. It really does piss me off. Not that I'd like Ryan or Mackenzie for that matter, but should Macy have this much power? Like, if you remember, she wanted, you know, Farah off because she didn't want her son on somebody that was doing PORN, etc., etc. But it seems okay for the people that she cares about. So, for Amber, example, you know, she's okay to have a addiction problem. She's okay for DV. She's okay for all this stuff. The hypocrisy with this girl is so high. It's unbelievable. I personally think that she shouldn't have this much power. If they want him to be fired, then that's on them and that's fair enough. But again, like MTV and Viacom fired Farah for being, well, being her. And yet they allow people like Amber Portwood to carry on the show, who has been to prison, who has had addiction issues, who, you know, is is very much an abusing person. I don't understand where the pattern goes or what's right and what's wrong. Why isn't Macy upset about the issues that Amber's bringing to the table, or even Butch for that matter? Do you know what I mean? Like, Caitlin and Tyler, they deal with addiction, they deal with all that with Butch and stuff like that, but that's okay. You don't want to get them fired. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, because for me personally, I don't know. I think it's a mess, and I think this girl got way too much power, and I don't think she's a bad person at all. I don't think she's a bad mum or anything like that, but I think her priorities are absolutely screwed. You can't possibly see that you're not a hypocrite from doing that. You're okay with everything that Amber have done. You're okay with Butch being an addict. You're okay with Tyler's sister being like it. And girl, you drink a lot. Like, I'm not even kidding. You drink a lot, a lot. You and your husband. What's the difference? I don't know. I just think there's one rule for the moms, and they can do what the heck they want. But what's her story going to be like? I think that's my question. It's like, what is your story going to be like without the whole Ryan drama? Because all you do is exploit the children at this point, you know? And that's not saying that's a bad thing or a good thing. It's just your storylines are pretty much Bentley. Your other three kids lead very normal, quote unquote, normal, boring lives. Your drama is Ryan, the Edwards and Bentley. So what are you going to be showing us going to training? Because you do push your kids a heck of a lot. And again, whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, I don't know. They're not my children. I just think they do a hell of a lot of after school activities. That's not going to be fun to watch. Like, I'm going to be ending up fast forwarding her part like I do, like some of the others. I just think it's crazy. I really do. But let me know what you think. So my next question is Ryan sober? Is he still using? Is Mackenzie enabling him? Is his parents enabling him? I don't know. I think yes, purely just by the way he has been lately, the way he looks. Like, if you remember back in the day, you know, Ryan was very much on his looks and his appearance, and you know, he was a cute little kid. Like, he was a cute boy, but he doesn't seem to care much about that anymore. And I'm pretty sure that she is enabling him to a degree. It wouldn't surprise me at all. But I don't know. If I'm honest, I really don't know. I think he's not. I don't think he's straight at all. I think he's still doing something. But I don't think it's ever going to be that these people are not enabling him. He's gone from a spoiled brat to a spoiled adult. His mum still wipes his butt. You know, it has got to that point that he legitimately cannot do a dang thing without somebody there doing it for him. And it's normally his mum. And I do blame her and his father. Whether it's the only child syndrome, potentially it could be. But, like, come on. At some point, surely you've got to grow up and not expect your mum or dad or wife to bail you out of the crap you got yourself into. And, you know, he said, I think it was last episode or the episode before, oh, well, it's just Macy putting all this crap into Bentley's head. You do know this kid can go on Google, right? You are aware of that. He can just Google your name. It is that simple. Just Googling your name will bring up everything you've ever done and said. And let's be fair, like, what the things that you have said about his mum and him himself is pretty gross. It's not good. It's not fun. That's terrible. But you seem to be okay with that. And this kid is, what, 12? is perfectly capable of going onto Google, writing in your name, and seeing all the crap that comes up. And, you know, I'm just going to run over what your father said. I'm not going to let my son go for anything. I think he needs to let you go. He needs you to hit rock bottom because you haven't. Nobody lets you hit rock bottom. You are so enabled that it's absolutely crazy. Insane. I just don't understand a grown baby like him who's got all these children and still being enabled and by his parents. I don't get it. Like, Bentley is such a good kid and he's really lost his spark over this last season. Like, the few seasons now he's been getting that way, but this season is very, very noticeable. He's lost his little bit of, like, funk. He's lost that. He's just lost it. He's lost that innocence, and that's your fault, and that's on you. And you've got to live with that for the rest of, you know, your life, knowing that you've let your son's innocence be taken because of your bad choices in life. That's sad. That's sad to me. That really is sad. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, all the good stuff. And I shall speak to you all again soon. Bye, guys.